Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel and welcome to all my new subscribers. Thank you for being here. So this reading is What's Their Karma for Hurting You? But before I start, I just want to give a quick shout out to somebody that wasn't happy with the reading that they were watching the other day. You know, some of you may feel that way as well. The person said that it took too long to get to the karma. Now, when you're a tarot reader, you have to find out, you know, what happened. You can't go into what's their karma straight away, because how do you bloody know whether that's your pile or not? So that's the reason why it's done the way it's done, is you get the background of the, you know, the story, and then you can decide whether that's your pile. Okay, if it's not, then you choose another pile. So that's how I do the karma readings. You know, by all means, fast forward to the karma, but do you know whether that's your pile or not? You know, you don't. You know, tarot readers, some of them would just basically do that straight away, but that's not a genuine tarot reader in my eyes. But anyway, so enough moaning or babbling, whatever you want to call it. Group one, this is your card, flight. Let's rise into the sky. Group two, we have leaving, new horizons to be sought. Then group three, we have, love that card, transformation, becoming me. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything, don't forget their energies as well. If it's not your pile, choose another pile. If it's not here, your reading, I have a playlist with karma readings there. You know, you can go have a nosy. So I'll see you at your piles. Hey group ones, if you chose flight with this card, you escape something with the person that hurt you, okay? This is their karma. They can't hold you back anymore. They can't control you anymore. So this is an escape card, okay? You finally are free of whatever it was that this person did to you, okay? You're at this new beginning here of, you know, great adventures, or just feeling excited about the future here. You know, you could have already gone through all that, so you know. But anyway, let's have a look at what this person did to you. So spirit, please tell me, what did this person do to group one? What did they do? How did they hurt my lovely group ones? What did they do to hurt them all? Okay, we have the Nine of Coins, the Three of Coins, the Eight of Swords, the Five of Swords, and the Six of Coins. Let me take that, that's the overall energy, okay? Let's move that bloody out the bloody way. Okay, you're single, okay? You may not be, but you know, Nine of Coins is usually a single card, you know, living your best life, and that's what I said about that card here. This could be to do with work here with you guys, okay? Something that you were involved with here. You were in the Eight of Swords, and this is really not a good card in the tarot deck. This is being in a mental prison. This is feeling trapped. This is bullying as well that's going on. Abuse here with the Five of Swords, okay? You didn't think it was fair with it. It wasn't, when you were in this environment here, whatever it is, it may be work, it may be a relationship. I'm gonna have a look at this. It was hearing, I don't think this is work. Why am I hearing that whoever this was to you, they were maybe talking to multiple people, they may have been collaborating with one other person here, And the Eight of Swords is like, you know, when a narcissist will, you know what a narcissist is. That's the type of thing that I'm picking up here. Or a lot of gaslighting when it came to you, okay? And they put you in this mental state of just feeling so confused. You felt like you were going crazy. That's what I'm hearing. And this person abused you in that sense, okay? So if this is upsetting for you, please don't stay and watch, okay? But that's what I'm seeing here. There was abuse going on here, mental abuse, not physical, mental. This person was giving to other people here, not to you. But you were also giving to them as well. So it's like they were taking from other people, but taking from you as well. This person was very greedy. Tell me about the Five of Swords. Very selfish, very greedy. Tell me about the Five of Swords. This is someone you could have been married to, okay? Someone that you could have been in a serious commitment with. Three of Wands. Yeah, look, we've got three and we've got three. I see my threes as a third party. So I feel like this person may have stepped out of the relationship here and was literally giving to other people. But when you started to get suspicious, this person would gaslight you, and then you would become so like the Eight of Swords. So we've got Taurus energy here. Tell me more about the Five of Swords. The Emperor, yeah, this is Emperor's usually somebody's husband. Don't forget energies, it can be a wife as well. But this is somebody that abused the power that was given to them, okay? Because this is someone who is very strong-minded, very clever, okay? Can be very reliable. But because I'm clarifying the Five of Swords, this person abused their power. They saw the weakness in you, okay? And they made you very, like, confused all the time. I'm just hearing confusion. Tell me about the Eight of Swords. So we've got Aries energy. We've got the Eight of Cups. Yeah, this is you walking away. And that clarifies this here. You walking away, but they could have walked away and left you. We've got the Two of Cups. We've got the Lovers. Now, this is very weird. We've got the Stars. And I'm going to admit something to you here. We've got the Wheel of Fortune. I'm going to put these down and I'm going to tell you why in a minute. Now, I'm not being. This is so weird, okay? Literally, these cards here that I've just pulled out from the back of the deck. Now, you saw me shuffling these cards quite a few times. I had trouble doing your pile group one. I had to restart the recording and I'm not kidding you. I thought to myself, if I literally do not get it on this one, I am gonna leave it today. So it took me five times to do your pile because there was a lot of confusion. And now that explains a lot of things because I just clarified the Eight of Swords. I felt very confused. And now that's not like me. I can go into a reading. Sometimes I'll have trouble, but not all the time. And this is the state of mind that they put you in. And you've literally drawn out again the cards that were there in your pile before and before and before. So obviously there's a serious message here for you. So I hope I explained that for you know. So you walked away from this Emperor, and that is what that card means, their flight here. You know, you may have thought this person was your soulmate. They may have been your soulmate, but don't forget they can also be your karmic soulmate because we've got the Wheel of Fortune here with the Two of Cups. But you did really love this person, but the hurt and the pain that they caused you made you walk away from them because you couldn't do it anymore. I feel like for some of you, you may have even had a breakdown, okay? You know, a mental breakdown because you know you wasn't the only option in this person's life with the Lovers here. They wasn't just choosing you, they were choosing other people here, or maybe one person. You have healed from this with the Star. Love to see that. And this, look, we've got the Wheel of Fortune, which is karma. This is their karma, is that you walked away from them. You have healed from this. You are living your best life here with the Nine of Coins. You know, you may not be interested in getting involved with anybody, okay? You may have even worked with this person. You know, you may have had a company together. You know, you may have given this person ideas on their business. You know, that's because the Three of Coins is there. That is a work card as well. But look at this. You've literally got flight with her jumping in the air, and then you've got the Six of Wands, which is victory, happiness, and then the Fool, which is a new beginning. You took that leap of faith, okay? You went into the unknown. You didn't know where you were going to end up, but you just was like, I'm done. I will take my chance. I'm not hanging around no more. So what energies have we got here? So we have Taurus, we've got Aries, we've got Gemini, you've got major arcana here as well. So this was a major event that happened to you or is happening to you, okay? You know, this is a valuable lesson that you had to learn. We've got Aquarius. Yeah, major arcana here for you guys. And the karma here for this person, and obviously we're going to go into the karma, but the karma for this person is watching you succeed, watching you blossom, watching you, you know, go on and have a beautiful new beginning, you know, on your own or with somebody else. This is their karma. They have to watch that. I feel like I'm just hearing they made a mistake. So tell me more, what did this person do to group one to hurt them, spirit? What did they do? Oh, Ten of Coins in reverse. Now, I never get the Ten of Coins in reverse. You know, Queen of Swords as well. She or he can be narcissistic. You know, cruel, mean, spirited, you know, just a bully. I feel like this person was very controlling as well with you, but they've become very obsessed with you, okay? It's like, you know, with narcissists, it's like, how can you leave me, you know? I don't know whether any of you have watched, caught glimpses of it, the Married at First Sight, the new one, the Australian one I'm on about. Some of you may know what I'm on about, and that guy that is with that really beautiful bird, and that he started off on the day of the wedding of him lying about having a girlfriend. For some of you, if you know what I'm on about, but oh my god, this guy is what you call a narcissist. I'm on about, look, I'm not violent, but you know when you want to punch someone on the nose, he is awful. And that's the kind of energy I'm picking up for you guys, is that the gaslighting and the narcissists in this person. And you know, this is what I'm seeing here for you guys. It was just like, it was awful for you. And then the Ten of Coins in reverse. So this, my light's flickering, and when that does that, I take that as confirmation from spirit. There was a financial loss here, okay? You guys built generational wealth here, okay? Or this person could have come from generational wealth, okay? From a wealthy background. It's gone. They've experienced some kind of loss here, and this could be their karma right now. This could have happened while you were together. This is business failure here. Tell me about the Ten of Coins here. But then they could have caused this, because I want to know what they did to hurt you. Tell me about the Ten of Coins. This could have been your wealth. They could have destroyed everything you worked for here while you were with them, you know? As I said, giving to other people. Tell me about the Ten of Coins. That's come out like that. I don't know. High Priestess, the Empress. Yes, look, I'm going to take them like this, guys, okay? They came out for a reason like that. High Priestess, the Empress. We've got Divine Masculine and Feminine here. We've got Justice on its side as well. We've got the World. This, seriously, I never get this many major arcana in a reading. You went through some hardships here. So we've got the King of Swords, we had the Queen of Swords on the back of the deck. So that is a divorced couple, okay? That's two people not seeing eye to eye here, okay? Okay. So we've got Libra, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius again. So strong air sign here. We've got, yeah. So this person was very ignorant as well, okay? So because I'll clarify the Ten of Coins in reverse. Very ignorant. They were holding back something as well. I feel like they were holding you back here because you know, you guys are the Empress here. The Divine Feminine should not be on her side like that. But it also could be that the secret was that they had an Empress that was like this. This person was holding you back from being the Empress that you should have been. You know, there was, like I said, Empress should not be on her side like that. That was them, the controlling in the relationship, okay? The control that they had a hold of you, put you on, you know, in this energy like this, of feeling confused, you know, feeling abused. And then justice on its side here as well. This is, you know, justice like this as well is abuse. It's like just, you've got so much abuse here, but it was mental abuse. You know, a lot of dishonesty. You were dealing with a karmic here as well, okay? Like I said, you may have thought this was your soulmate, but this is a karmic soulmate here. So this person could have actually wasted all the funds, you know, the whatever you built up together here, okay? They wasted... I wasted a lot here. Oh. This is somebody that lacks success, okay? But they also didn't want you to succeed in anything here. They wanted you to be stuck. You know, the King of Swords. Is that the King of Swords or the Knight of Swords? No, the King of Swords. This is a narcissistic card as well, the King of Swords. He comes out, my King of Swords, as the narcissist. So this is someone who's very aggressive and brutal, can be controlling. But I feel like what they did to you here, it's like spirit is going straight into the karma here as well, because this could be what they're experiencing now. You could have taken your wealth, your ideas and what have you when you left. And this person's now in the energy of literally being unsuccessful, not succeeded in anything. They're stuck. So I feel like this person had multiple affairs, okay? This person wasn't faithful. And you found out and you left it behind because they literally was abusing you in a way that they no one should ever be abused. So let me look at their karma here. Hang on. Bear with me because I'm looking at my oracle cards and whether to do that first or do... No. Spirit's saying do this first. So tell me, Spirit, what more did this person do to group one? Tell us more. And then I'll do the karma, okay, guys? Oh, blimey. So we've got sneaky behaviour. They're not always where they say they are going to be. Okay, clarifies that. Lies, lies, lies. Controlling an effort to control your behaviour. They lied to you. Now, did I not say that this person was very controlling? It was like mind control. lies again. Cover, they wear a mask and pretend to be something they are not. Tell me more about this energy here, that hurt group one. Manipulation, they use the situation to make you feel guilty for expressing your concerns in the first place. I love it when spirit confirms what I've said. We have cheating. There's an emotional connection with someone else. So this, because I was a bit confused about the work card here, this could have been a work affair, okay? It could have something to do with someone that they worked with. But I feel like you were involved as well with this company or whatever it is that this person did. But I feel like it was taking your ideas. And now the reason why this person is so stuck when it comes to the business success and finances and stuff is because they don't have you. Okay? And justice also, like, this can also be like going through a legal battle with someone, you know, and they could have lost this legal battle. So we have that, right, and yeah, we've got that one. And then we've got cheating again. Double life, they act single when you're not around. Lots of flirting and questionable behaviour. So they may have removed their wedding ring. Cheating, there's heavy flirting via text or sexting taking place, perhaps even more. So that may be how you found out, guys. You know, saw something on their phone. I want more from this energy here. What do they want to tell group one? This is coming from their higher self, okay? Unavailable. I know you're a catch and I love your company, but I just want to have fun and keep my options open. That's just it. They may have been committed, but they weren't fully committed. Fear. I had a hard time trusting our connection and chose to run from you. I had a hard time trusting anyone. That's absolute crap. See, that may have been, you know, the manipulation there, you know, oh my God, I was hurt in the past. You know, all the crap that people come out with. Distraction. I lost track of all my budding relationships. Whatever. Let's get their personality. Tell me about the person's personality for group one, please, spirit. And then go into the... We've got philosopher. Obsessive and disdainful, doesn't function well within terms, blind preference for their own perspective, overlook solutions due to overconfidence. Yeah, this person's got a big ego. We have hermit. Recluse, defensive, deep trust towards humanity, judges others who live differently, wants nothing to do with the outside world. I don't believe that though. I feel like this person that is very judgy, okay, but I also feel like that when you go to attack their character or point something out about them, they become very defensive and then they tend to project. Killer. Methodical. Knows what to do to avoid suspicion. Charismatic. Investigative. Intelligent. Trustworthy. Non-discriminatory. And calculating. But that's just it. You know, this person has a very sly, sneaky energy about them. Clever. So let's have a look. What is their karma for her in group one, please, spirit? What is the karma for her in group one? Four of Wands. Page of Cups. Five of Cups. There you go. Karma for her, for hurting you here with these three cards here, is they lost out on being married to you here. You could have been you could have been each other's twin flame here, but maybe this person didn't notice that. But this person, the karma is that the reason they lost out on this marriage here, because this is a marriage and commitment, and you know your home and your family, and I feel like they lost that is because this person is so childish, very manipulative as well as a liar, okay, and they also were given it to other people here. You know, they may have developed romantic feelings for someone, which we've already said that. And then we've got the Five of Cups here, which speaks of being in grief, feeling the loss, feeling rejected, you know, feeling heartbroken. This is regret here. And their karma is the regretfulness of what they had with you. Now they're dealing with people that are very immature, you know, not fully grown, or just very childish, you know. Tell me, what's the karma of Page of Wands? What's the karma for her in Group 1? Page of Wands, okay. So they're experiencing a lot of setbacks here, but then we do have... Wow. Okay. I'll take it. So yeah, they're experiencing a lot of setbacks here. Okay, and I feel like it is to do with... They can't seem to find anybody that's on their level, okay? You were the Empress, the Divine Feminine. You know, that you could be the mother of their children or the father of their children. But they literally now are dealing with... Sorry to say it, idiots. Okay. So then we've got the King of Cups. I'll put it. No, actually. Oof. The Tower. Seven of Cups. Death. The Moon. Ace of Wands. And the Ten of Wands. Oh, whatever. Never mind. So we've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Pisces, sorry. We've got Scorpio as well. The karma is that they're experiencing tower moment after tower moment. And when it comes to the tower moments, it's to do with the fact that they are still looking towards you. They... You know, don't get me wrong, you may not want to hear it, but this person does still love you, okay? They did love you, but in a very sick way, okay? If that's what you can call love. So their tower moment that they're experiencing is basically that they have to watch you go off and do your own thing, be happy, live your life here. And also the tower moment that they're experiencing is that they're going through so many different people at the moment. Like I said, they can't find anybody that's you. So it's like they're constantly searching for that missing piece, because we did have the Divine Feminine and Masculine here. You know, that's two counterparts. But sometimes someone carries the dark energy and there's nothing you can do about it. And this person does carry that dark energy, you know. They're experiencing maybe an ego death here, or some kind of ending that's coming, that's happening to them. But it also could be that where they're starting these relationships with these young people and they're not working out, they're constantly having to end it. So this is a bad change, this is a bad situation for this person that they've put themselves in. They can't break away from these bad things that are happening to them at the moment, which is the karma. And then we have the Moon. This person's in despair. That's with the energy that they put you in. This is a person that has the inability to move forward, and I feel like, and this would make sense with the Death card there, this is like literally a bad situation, a bad ending here, and that's what spirit is doing. It's like you're not moving forward because of all the lies and deception, you know, and the things that you did to group one here. And the thing is, this person, okay, they're resisting changing. It's like they feel their ego is so big here that they feel like that they are so powerful and they can control the, you know, the situation here. But this person, I feel like, is not a believer in the spiritual side of things. Okay, I don't feel like they believed in anything like that. So they believe in, you know, the physical, which is being here, not what they can't see. And spirit is like, we're going to be teaching you a lesson here until you get the message. And they just can't see it. So they wanted this brand new beginning here with the Ace of Wands. They were really, you know, feeling passionate and excited and what have you, but it's not happening. They're just receiving setbacks, disappointments, delays, you know, the Ten of Wands. This is somebody that is carrying a lot of burdens around at the moment, trying to put their life back together, but it's not happening. This person's stressed, they're exhausted. So they could be in a mental prison now themselves. This is somebody that's got so many problems. This is like a mountain that they can't climb over. You know, they're trying to dig themselves out of this grave that they dug themselves into, and it's just, it's not happening. Tell me more. What's this person's karma for group one? Judgment. Okay, judgment. This is somebody that is literally feeling guilty constantly. You know, it's like it niggles at them for what they did. I feel like this person knows what they did, okay? And the guilt just overwhelms them at times, not that they would admit it. This person's experienced a lot of malicious gossip, a lot of... this person's being judged by a lot of people, so maybe it came out about what they did to you. Nine of Swords, yep, sleepless nights, worries. Four of Swords, they're not sleeping, they're not eating, they are having nightmares, and you know. Now with the Knight of Swords, this is someone that is just feeling out of their depth here. They just can't seem to get a break. This person's receiving really harsh karma here, and you know why I think that is because when I said about the Major Arcana here, you literally had so many and they put you through such a hard time, you know, to have that many Major Arcana, that's something very serious that is going on in your life. Now it's this person's time to experience what they put you through here. Seven of Swords. They're trying to recover from this. They're trying to walk away from the past here, but it's like spirit is pulling them back. You know, maybe giving them the nightmares here. So let's have a look in my karma cards. So spirit, tell me for group one, what is the karma for the person that hurt group one? What is the karma for the person that hurt group one? What did I say? They're having nightmares, did I not? Then having nightmares, they can't pay the bills, which we've seen here that they're at rock bottom here. No genuine friends. They're experiencing rejection, and that can be in, you know, coming, you know, something to do with their business here. you know, work, blocked finances. They will constantly be reminded of you. Yep. Undesirability, damage to property will be used for, you know. And I said that they're dealing with a lot of young'uns here that I feel like it's all about the money and, you know, using that, you know, the fun stuff to get what they want from this person, but they don't actually have the money to back it up. So what is the karma for this person that hurt group one? Abandonment. I wish I never wrote in this. Oh, never getting over losing you, you know, the heartbreak. Business failing, which is literally just clarifying everything I've said about this person here. And then we've got no help from others. Dreams will come true, but will quickly turn into hell. So basically, if they're getting it, literally within 5 minutes, it'll be gone. Their partner will cheat on them. Self-care neglect, so they may neglect their hygiene, and they will go grey. Okay, so it's basically their business. They're having nightmares, and it's like they're haunted by what they did to you here. Okay, their business is literally fallen apart here. You know, we had the Ten of Pentacles in reverse, and they obviously didn't realize that you were the one that brought value into their life. Okay, you were the treasure in this person's life, and they were just too stupid to notice it because their ego was so big. So group one, I'm going to leave it there. Okay, actually no, wait a minute. Let's get you a question card. So ask a question, and let's see what spirit says. Think of your question. Your answer is in the cards. Okay, fair enough, spirit, whatever. So there you go. So whatever you ask for, it's there. Okay, so you have a wonderful Saturday, guys. Much love. Hey, group two, so if you chose leaving with this card, okay, obviously it literally says it all here, is that you left this person, okay? You had to harden your heart to move away from this person. Yes, you may have shed a lot of tears while doing this, but it was for the best, is what spirit is saying here, you know? It says new horizons to be sought, and that's what you did, okay? So that's part of their comment. That don't sit like that, so we'll put it like that. Okay, let's have a look. So spirit, tell me please, what did this person do to group two to hurt them? We have the Page of Cups. What did they do to hurt group two? Two of Cups, Four of Coins, Two of Coins. Yeah, look, we have rejection here, okay? So yeah. This person, whoever you were dealing with, you know, they were very immature. They were full of empty promises. They would promise you one thing and then not follow through with it. They may have had like tantrums at times, you know, like outbursts and stuff. Let me have the Two of Cups. This person didn't bring you any kind of security, and maybe if you were living together or you were, you know, you were in a secure relationship with this person, the problem being is when it comes to actual emotional security, they did not offer you any of this. You know, you did, you did really love this person, okay? You saw this person as your soulmate. You were all in when you were in this connection, but this person, I feel like this person was really selfish, you know, like someone like is like a man child or a woman child, if you know, whatever. You know, constantly maybe, I don't know why I'm hearing that, you know, they ignored you a lot, okay? So it could be they may have played on their PlayStation, Xbox, whatever. It was just all about themselves. There was a very childish side to this energy here. You had to take on a lot of the responsibility in the relationship of juggling, you know. You may have had children with this person, but you did majority. You did, actually, I think you did the whole lot here. So not only was you having to juggle work and home and, you know, maybe children, if you got children with this person did not contribute to any of it, and it put you in a state of mind of that you were just exhausted. Exhausted. Okay, so tell me more, please, spirit, of what this person did to hurt group one, two, please. You know, I'm hearing that you said to yourself, basically, when you left this person, that sometimes it's better to just be on your own, because you felt alone, if you know what I mean. Yeah, look, Knight of Wands here. Tell me about the Knight of Wands. About the night. Okay. Eight of Swords. Page of Wands. Ten of Coins. Five of Swords. The World. The Queen of Wands. Oh dear. Did they? Yes, they did. Yeah, they did. Okay. I didn't think there would be any kind of cheating going on in this reading. But now I'm seeing that there was something going on here. I feel like this person had maybe things going on with people online, okay? They may have even had an online profile somewhere, you know, one of those dating apps or something, because there's a Queen of Wands here, and I see this as the third party. Also, the Knight of Wands speaks to someone that is very in and out. They are a player, okay? They can't keep it in their pants, okay? Very lustful energy here. So yeah, the Page of Wands is a lot of communication here, so back and forth, like with somebody here, you know. The World is an online card. You know, you invested a long time with this person, you thought this was guaranteed with the Ten of Coins here, okay? But they put you in the Eight of Swords, which was just feeling like alone, trapped, exhausted, like I said. You know, this could have been an abusive relationship as well. So a bit of a trigger warning here. There may have been violence in the relationship. There may have been emotional abuse in the relationship. This person had a lot of control over you guys, okay? I feel like you were scared of them. And like I said, the Queen of Wands, she is seen as the other person, the other party, you know. Let me have a look. So we've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, strong fire sign in this reading, okay? Yeah, fire sign right here. So tell me about this Queen of Wands. Spirit. King of Cups. Third party. This person, the Tower. I feel like your person was having an emotional affair with somebody online, okay? I mean, it may have developed into something more, but there was feelings involved here. They were very attracted to this Queen of Wands. You know, the King of Cups is somebody that's invested, you know, in love. And the Three of Coins can be seen as a third party. So tell me about the Three of Coins. This could have even been a work relationship, okay? It may have started as an emotional affair first. Tell me about the Three of Coins. They work with this person. Yeah, look, online again. They were reckless with your feelings. They were reckless. They didn't think about it. They did not think things through. They ruined their Ten of Coins here. They could have had generational wealth with you here. You know, They could have had it all with you, but no, their lusty energy here decided that there was something better out there for them, you know. And this Queen of Wands is very clever because she uses her assets, okay, her looks to lure people in, okay. So I do feel like this was some kind of work thing going on, because the King of Coins is a business owner or somebody that's doing very well in the business sense. But so there was a lot of online stalking or online communication here. And the Knight of Swords is somebody that just was really reckless, you know, just didn't really care of the consequences here. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. My throat keeps going. So tell me more, please. Tell me more. Karma. The Fool. Queen of Swords. Yeah, this person hurt you. Look at this. You know, in both piles, Justice and the Wheel came out. And obviously, we're doing a karma reading here, aren't we? So, idiot. I'm an idiot. This makes me laugh. This really does make me laugh. I'll tell you about that in a minute. So this person obviously is receiving some kind of karma here for what they did to you, okay? But this is Justice. This person made a decision here to leave you for the Queen of Wands, okay? So this person decided that the Queen of Wands was a better option. But what they didn't realise is they got involved with a karmic here, okay? But this is part of their karma. You know, this may make you smile now. So they've gone off, they took this leap of faith with this Queen of Wands here, but they ended up with the Queen of Swords. This was just an illusion, because if you have a look at the mirror here, this person was showing this person the side that they wanted them to see, okay? Not the real them. And this is what's happened here. They got the Queen of Swords, somebody that is very controlling, someone that can be very malicious and cruel and nasty, you know, very obsessive. So maybe she's got this control over your person here. So he or she was in for a big, big surprise here, like a big slap in the face. And then we've got the Wheel of Fortune, which is karma, you know. This is karmic justice, because this person did not realise that you were the Ten of Coins here, which is the generational wealth, that you were someone so valuable to them, but they didn't see it. You know, they thought they were going off with their new beginning here. I feel like they may have caught an STD here as well, because when I see the wands in certain cards and they've got things growing out of it, I mean, what does that look like, okay? So I feel like they may have caught something from the Queen of Swords or the Queen of Wands, because she is the Jezebel energy, okay? But, you know, the Queen of Coins, she is somebody that is so humble, so sincere, you know, very giving, loyal, kind, and they took advantage of this. And obviously Spirit stepped in with the two karma cards and was like, well, hell no. So, yeah, they did the deed here. They were naughty. So tell me about Justice and the Wheel. Maybe getting a bit of karma reading already, but I'll still go into that anyway at the end. Tell me about the Wheel and Justice, please, Spirit. Knight of Coins. King of Wands. Death. Three of Swords. Ace of Cups. Here we go. My eye is really hurting since starting your reading. This is very weird. So, you know, these two could have been together for a long time, okay? Because we do have a couple here with the King of Wands. We have Scorpio energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So, yeah, they, you know, this person may have ended up marrying this person, okay? They were in a relationship. They were in, well, your person was in love. But it came to an end here. their heart's been broken here, and this is clarifying part of their karma, because like I said, there are two karma cards here. So they've experienced the Three of Swords, which could be that they were put in a third party here, okay? So, you know, the saying of the wheel is what goes around comes around. So I feel like they were together for a while here, or they may have been sneaking around together for a while, and this person may have even left your person for a third party, okay? So take what resonates here. But someone definitely cheated, and that could be why they ended up with an STD, you know? So we've already got some of their karma cards here, so let's see what their higher self wants to say to you before I go into karma. Tell me more. Differences. I knew I had to increase my effort to be with you. I wasn't able to do that, which we already see that, because they just wasn't invested, whereas you was. Unavailable. I'm pretty happy on my own, which came out upside down, by the way, guys. I'm pretty happy on my own and was fearful of it changing. I'm not really a relationship type of person. It's best you move on. But that is in reverse. So basically, this is a load of crap is what they're saying. They are not happy on their own. They're feeling the pain. We have the Three of Swords. That is a very painful ending. Immature, which I said right at the beginning. I prefer superficial relationships that don't challenge me. Dating you was a little too much for me. Okay, love. So basically, Spirit's saying they were immature. So let's see what else. So we have sneaky behaviour, witchcraft. Someone is casting spells to control a situation. So just be careful with this person. They could be maybe into the dark arts here, you know. Yeah, just be careful. Just cleanse yourself, okay? Protect yourself. Get some sage or something. Manipulation. They say one thing but do another, giving you mixed messages. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Sneaky behavior. They're engaging in some risky behavior. Be sure to protect yourself and be safe. So they could have given you the STD. Okay, that may have been how you found out. Bad traits. Cold-hearted. They are out of touch with their deeper feelings. Let's get a couple more. Bad traits again. Paranoia, suffering from paranoia, just waiting for you to slip up or be unfaithful is driving, or to be unfaithful is driving them mad. But that's just it, you know, when people cheat, okay? When they cheat, they tend to project, okay? They start accusing you of cheating. So it could be if there was money involved or something like that, they will, you know, maybe trying to gather evidence. You know, we did have the Page of Swords. So that is like spying, trying to gather information on someone. So they were hoping maybe to, you know, if there was a court battle or something, or, you know, a payout, you know, if some countries, if one cheats, the person gets, you know, more. Whereas here, that doesn't count in the UK because they don't care. So, yeah, they were trying to find out whether you were doing the same thing, because then they could go away and act like the victim. But yet that didn't work because you're not the one that was cheating. And then when I said about the abuse here, mental abuse, they gaslight you and send you mixed signals. And that's what they were doing to you. So let's get their personality type. Oh, God. I'm going to do that again. Your cards are just bloody flying out. So we've got Challenger. Intimidating, difficult. Difficulty following rules set by others, confrontational, unmoving, tyrannical, disregards opinions and feelings of others. Yeah. And then we've got high chair tyrant. Sorry. Demanding, incapable of taking criticism, brat, narcissistic, fails to take responsibility, needs constant attention, entitled and arrogant. Now, I said that at the beginning, that this person is like a child. It's like, it's like I said, if you are a mum or a father, it was like you were a parent to this person as well, is what I said at the beginning. There you go. That confirmed that then. So let's get their karma. Let's see what the karma is. I'm going to get some different cards. Yeah, got one. So spiritually, what's the karma for this person that hurt group two? We've already got seen some of their karma anyway here, guys, okay? So we've got the Three of Coins again. Did we get the Three of Coins? Did we get the Three of Coins? I think we did. So we've got the Three of Coins. So that could be maybe they lost their job. Sublime. Got Six of Wands. Business is not doing so well. Work is not doing so well for this person. The Emperor in reverse, because they are a bloody abuser, this person is. Now I did say that this person could be the one experiencing the abuse now, okay? Now with the Emperor in reverse, this is someone that is abusive, controlling, abuses the power that they have over someone. So they thought they were all like, you know, I can't swear, they thought they were going to be the ones that was going to be happy and succeeding, and I'm going to be doing so well for myself, I'm really happy in my relationship. No, that's not what happened. They got, you know, that saying I said, what goes around comes around. This is someone who is actually very weak-minded, okay? They're very weak-minded. I can't even say this person is actually a real divine masculine here. They're not. This is someone who is being controlled, like I'm on about excessively being controlled by someone, and that is the Queen of Swords. I shouldn't laugh, but anyway, never mind. And I feel like part of their karma is that they're the Queen of Wands here. The person that they ended up with is actually talking to other people. I don't feel like work is going very well here for this person. What's their karma for hurting? Oh my God. Okay. So we have the Ace of Pentacles. I said work won't go very well for this person. Maybe they've lost their job. So part of their karma could be that they lost their job, or the business could be failing here. The Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Wow. We've got the Page of Cups again, the Page of Wands in reverse, and we have the Seven of Swords, which is sneaky behavior, and then the Hierophant. Yeah, so this person could have gone on to marry this person or be in a committed relationship with them, but they're experiencing some drastic changes and problems in their life. They're lacking in finances here, okay? So they could be dealing with somebody that has a gambling problem here with the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So they're also dealing with somebody that is having trouble with their weight, okay? So this person could be the one that's put a lot of weight on. Their health is not so great. They could be the one that's got a gambling problem, and that's why there's no money left. So it could be the person that they ended up with or their energy here. So this is part of their karma. They're dealing with someone who is a liar now. We've got the Page of Cups and the Page of Cups here. So they're now literally attracted like for like, you know. And then the Page of Wands in reverse. This is setbacks again. This is someone that you're dealing with, somebody that is very shallow, very ungrounded here, okay, very immature, very childish. It's like basically opposites attract, isn't it? Or actually, no, they're not opposites, they're actually two peas in a pod. This is somebody that's realizing that they've made a huge mistake and their conscience is starting to kick in now, and they're like, crap, I made a huge mistake. Fucking hello. So tell me more about this person's karma for group two. So, ten of coins. And the five of wands. Oh dear. Ten of swords. This person's betrayed them. This is what I was saying though. There could have been that this person cheated on this person here, okay? So the Queen of Wands, I feel like, did cheat. They betrayed them. Because the Five of Wands is seen as a rival in love. It can be seen as just constant arguments, fights. So there was a lot of arguments going on with these two, a lot of fights, a lot of people getting involved here. The Ten of Coins is, you experience the Ten of Coins in reverse. Yes, it is outright, but I'm seeing it as, I said, what goes around comes around. This is lack of money. This is no finances here. They've been betrayed. I feel like the Queen of Wands is overspent. I feel like they may have even taken them for everything that they've got. So if they did take the generational wealth away from you, okay, and left you in poverty, this is now their karma here. So let's have a look at my cards. So tell me more, what's the karma for this person who are at group two, please, spirit? Smelly bits. Now, what does that say? I said about the STD, you know, that can cause smelly bits. Triggered in their next relationship, which is what's happened. This relationship has triggered them in so many ways, but they triggered you. They will go grey. Okay. People will stab them in the back, which we've got the Five of Wands here. We have, they will never get over you, basically, is that one. No doors will open for this person. So young door, I feel like the spirits closed the door in this person's face. So what is the karma for the person that hurt group? Two, losing friends. Yeah, see, the friends could have ended up falling out with them as well, because that is a friendship card with the Five of Wands as well. It could be that people just, you know, stabbing them in the back and, you know, just not supporting them. So we've got damaged property. Ghosted by friends and lovers. They will never find real love in this lifetime. This energy here could be having a problem with their eyes, okay? Some serious problem with their eyes, because honestly, I don't know what is going on with my right eye here, but it really. Yep, my eyes feels very weird. Their valuables will be stolen. Well, let's just take them, why not, eh? Legal issues, toxic relationships, business failing, I said that as well. Will not be able to forget you. Self-care neglect, that could be them putting on the weight. Will not be able to manifest anything. Will not be able to connect to anyone emotionally. People will talk shite about them, which is the Five of Wands. Abandonment, which I said, I feel like this Queen of Wands has left them. Dreams will come true, but will quickly turn into hell, and reputation will be ruined. There you go. So basically, this person's having some harsh karmas, harsh realities put on them by spirit here. So group two, I'm going to leave it there. Okay, so you have a lovely Saturday. Much love, guys. Hey, group three. So if you chose transformation, this is your reading. So with this card, you overcame something, okay? you overcame fear, maybe you know, because we have becoming me, so maybe whoever you was, or whoever this is that you had to become somebody that they wanted you to be, okay? But you've transformed. You know, there was a lot of fear surrounding you guys when you took this leap of faith, okay? Because I'm feeling the fall energy here. And it may even be that you've had some kind of glow up, or, you know, that this just, you are just like a totally different person, and this energy here, whoever they are, cannot bear to see that this transformation in you, okay? So let's have a look. So tell me, please, Spirit, what did this person do to group three to hurt them? What did they do? God, in the Magician, manipulation, strength, the Lovers, the Hermit. Tell me about the Lovers. Jesus, so much going on outside today. Bloody hell, I hate the weekends around here because we live by a holiday camp. Literally 2 minutes up the road, and it's coming up to summer, and I'm moaning, but it's just so bloody noisy. But anyway, so I wanted to confirm the Lovers before I said anything, okay? So let's have a look. We've got the Ace of Wands in reverse, the Emperor in reverse. Okay, you know what? Today should have been what's your ex's karma, because literally this has been every pile has literally been a partner. High Priestess in reverse, the Four of Cups in reverse, the King of Cups in reverse, jeez, the Star in reverse, oh my goodness, and the Wheel, and that's come out in every reading as well, which is karma. The World in reverse, the Hierophant in reverse, jeez, Justice in reverse, oh my God. So this was a partner of yours, someone that you were involved with, and as I said, I feel like this person was a master manipulator in controlling you, okay? And like I said, you break free, you become a person that they don't recognize anymore, okay? You're strong, okay? I feel like this person kept you secluded. I feel like they hid from everybody what they were doing to you. And not only that, group three, I feel like you had to put on a mask here and act like nothing was wrong in front of people, okay? So you were wearing a mask, they were wearing a mask, everything was fine, you know, when really you just wanted to break down and tell people that, you know, my life is an absolute mess, this person is an absolute disaster here. They cause a lot of setbacks in your life, okay? A lot of disasters, you know, just a lot of problems when it came to what they were doing to you. The Emperor here was somebody that was not the Divine Masculine here. This is someone that had power over you, okay? So this is a bit of a trigger warning as well. So they could have been abusive towards you here. This is someone that was very ignorant. They were holding you back. So maybe I feel like for you lot, you weren't allowed to go anywhere, you weren't allowed to work, you weren't allowed to do nothing. There was just so much control here when it came to you. This was somebody that didn't love you, okay? This was unrequited. It was definitely unrequited with the King of the Knight of Cups here. There was no love here. It was just like you were like a possession to them. And I feel like this person may have gone out a lot, you know, socialized, but they never let you go with them, okay? This is really sad. It was like you had to stay home and be the good little wife or the good little husband. And this is awful. You know, you would look at this person and see them getting all their wishes, and, you know, all their dreams were coming true. They made you doubt yourself. They made you doubt your insanity here. You know, I feel like a lot of gaslighting was going on here with you guys, okay? They made you feel like you were going bloody crazy. You felt stuck. So there could have even been financial abuse here as well, guys, okay? It's like when you were with this person, you achieved nothing. That's how they wanted you. You experience frustration. You feel like you failed when it comes to this relationship. But you weren't the one that failed. Sorry, that's my dog sniffing under the door. I don't know if you heard that. Bog off, you. This is somebody you could be... You could have been married to somebody that is a different religion to you, okay? They have different values when it comes to what a woman should be like, you know. I'm picking up misogyny here quite strongly, okay? But don't forget, there are energies, guys, that even if you're a male watching this, this, you know, this happens to men as well, okay? This person experienced... impotence. I want to clarify that. Impotence here. There was abuse in the relationship as well. They never defended you. They took other people's side. You know, maybe you did try to communicate to other people, and then like people would look at you like you were the crazy one, you know, because that's what abusers do. There was an injustice that was caused to you here, a serious injustice, you know, dishonesty in the relationship, Spirit is saying you was dealing with a karmic here with the wheel here, you know, your fortune took a turn for the worse. So maybe there was some kind of karmic debt that you had to pay off that came from your ancestors here, you know, even though it's not fair at times, but sometimes we volunteer apparently to come into the real world and pay off the karmic debt for our ancestors so it doesn't happen to the generation that we leave behind, you know. So tell me about this Hierophant in reverse. Oh, hang on, before we do that. So we have Gemini, and you've got a lot of major arcana as well. So this is major that happened in your life. We've got Virgo, we've got Aquarius, we've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, we've got Aries, Taurus, and Libra. Okay, so tell me about this Hierophant in reverse. Tell me about the Five of Wands and the Six of Pentacles. Page of Swords, Six of Cups. The Devil, not surprised. The Chariot. Ten of Wands. Two of Wands. Nine of Wands. Okay, I feel like with this energy here where I said that this person may be a different background to you, okay, different religion, different, you know, culture. And, you know, in some cultures, like I said, the woman or the, you know, mainly the woman, really, when it comes to things like this, must stay at home, must do as they're told. Now, the Five of Wands speaks of outside influences getting involved, okay, you know, being attacked by other people. So... this person was giving to other people, okay? They were very generous with other people, but when it came to you, they wasn't. You had a lot of people spying on you, so it's like this, I mean, this is awful abuse. It's like I said, you couldn't go anywhere, you couldn't do anything, so you had a lot of people spying on you here. But I also feel like this person got involved with someone from their past as well, someone that brings, you know, back a lot of memories, and someone they couldn't let go of here, that they had a past with them. But this was very toxic, okay? This is like the devil energy, but this is also your, what they did to you, you know, like codependency, feeling stuck, being controlled, being, you know, it's abuse with the devil here. You were really stressed when you were with this person, okay? You just felt like there was just too many rules, you know, regulations, that kind of thing here. They wounded you so deeply. You feel like you had made the wrong choice here, but I feel like this person also feels like that because they had so much responsibility. When I feel like it's family that was involved here, okay? That they had to support family, so they couldn't go for... You know, maybe this was an arranged marriage or something, okay? They couldn't go and be with the person of the Six of Cups here. You know, they had to follow a certain tradition. And that's why it was unrequited here, but you got the backlash here. And I don't know why I'm picking up with this impotence here that this person may have actually been gay, okay? Was this, they were in love with somebody else here. Tell me, was this person gay, spirit, please? And I feel like you got the backlash of the resentment, the anger. I know that's a very personal, touchy subject to be asking here, but I'm really getting that strongly with this reading. Page of Wands, Queen of Pentacles, the Wheel. So we've basically got a yes here. So they may have been hiding their sexuality, okay? Obviously, if they come from a different kind of background, you know, this is seen as taboo here. Wheel here as well. Tell me about the Queen of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Tell me about the Queen of Pentacles. Six of Swords, which was on the back of the deck. Yeah, I'm seeing they wanted to be with somebody else here, okay? And as harsh as that, you know, what I'm saying is, they wanted to be with somebody else. This person was the one that they wanted to, you know, spend their life with. But it didn't happen for them. They see this person, they put this person on a pedestal, is what I'm hearing. They could still be communicating with one another. Or they were when you were together with this person, because we had the Page of Swords and we have the Page of Wands. This is a communication, okay? Tell me about the Devil. Oh, straight away. Seven of Wands. Yeah, see, look. Having to protect the reality, you know, the truth about themselves here. This is what they were hiding, that there is something dark about this person. Not saying that sexuality is dark, but... the darkness when it came to how they treated you, okay? Like I said, they'll make out that you were the one that was crazy, you know? But also having to protect the secret that they've been holding on to for so long. And I feel like group three, you found out, okay? You realised that there was something going on here. Ace of Swords in reverse. You know, that is truth and clarity, the Ace of Swords there. That's the truth that came out. And that's what I was just saying, the Four of Pentacles and the Three of Swords in reverse. Queen of Swords. So yeah, they had to protect this secret at all costs. This is someone who was very confused, knew that it just wasn't going to work, okay? Just very confused, you know, about their sexuality here, of what they wanted. Very sad, really, but to put you through that is absolute BS. You know, this person had to let go of this person here. They had to do what they were told, basically. You know, this is letting go. And then the Three of Swords is, you know, is heartbreak. So what more should we know about what this person did to group three? Tower, they bought Five of Swords. Look at that. This person was very abusive to you, group three. You know, that is bullying, abuse, mental abuse, hardships, tower moments after tower moment. You know, you thought you were getting one thing, but you literally got a different, you know, a totally different thing to what you were believing you were getting. Tell me about the tower. King of Swords, narcissist, control freak, abusive. My King of Swords is always the one that is the worst in the deck when it comes to abuse, okay? When he's in reverse. This is someone that can be really brutal as well, and controlling, and has no integrity. He's just he or she was just an awful person. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You know, you were married to this person, okay? You could have had a family with them, but you built a life with this person, okay? You thought you were getting your happy ever after, but you got this King of Swords here. So let's find out what the karma is. But before I do that, tell me about the personality of this King of Swords, please, Spirit. Crime fighter, control freak. Oh my goodness. Twisted sense of humour, overworked, chaotic lifestyle, isolation, untrusting, catastrophic, I can't say that, thinking, suspicious and lonely. Yes, I've literally just described this person down to a T with that card here. A control freak, lonely, you know, doesn't trust you because they're projecting onto you here. Tell me more, please, Spirit. Child. Naivety, ignorance, overdependence, tantrums, stubbornness, sulkiness, moodiness, unprepared, draining and overwhelmed. And then we have Midas. Greedy, hoarder, fears losing money or status, very demanding or drains others, very controlling, pessimistic and inflexible. There you go. So let's see what their higher self wants to tell you here. Circumstances, even though it was difficult for me to ghost you, I know that it's for the best. So it could have been this person disappeared for days, you know, ghosting you all the time, you know, maybe like you didn't even know where they were when they were coming home. Maybe you ended up ghosting them. Right, we have careless. I didn't see your worth until it was too late. You didn't deserve that. Would you forgive me? That's their higher self, by the way. Communication. It's really difficult to compromise with you because you're not doing what you're told. That's why. differences. We are just too different to make us work. I didn't want to hurt your feelings. Absolute crap. This is, see, now this is very funny, actually, these cards coming through here. It just shows you the manipulation, the mind games that this person actually played with you. The gaslighting, that I'm so wonderful, you know, how can you think that of me? That's what I'm hearing. Circumstances, I didn't want to reveal what's been really going on in my life and unload all my personal issues on you. I just wanted to be left alone, and that's the problem. They did not want to admit what was really going on. Distraction, I got distracted by someone else I'm dating. I'm sorry. So maybe they were still involved with this person here and they kept it a secret. So let's get some, what is their karma? Oh, actually, no, we ain't done that yet. Ooh. Cards, am I gonna get, what's the karma for this person that hurt group three? Where's the karma? Four of cups, ten of cups. They're not going to receive their happy ever after here, okay? They're going to feel so dissatisfied and discontent with their life here, okay? This is part of their karma. They want their happily ever after with this person, whoever it is. It's not going to happen for them. The Hierophant marriage, you know, commitment, you know, that's not happening neither. They know they can't have that. The Magician, you've got Saint cards are coming out, Two of Pentacles, the Fool, the King of Cups. So the part of their karma here is you can keep manifesting this person into your life or changes or whatever you, and you know, manipulate people and that, but that's going to start backfiring here for this person, okay? They're going to be experiencing quite a lot of confusion, okay? I feel like they're going to be manipulated by somebody here. This is someone that's made a lot of poor decisions in their life, okay? They're really unbalanced at the moment. They're like, they've made so many poor decisions here when it comes to their life here, how they treated you. They're thinking they're going off into a new beginning here with, you know, they're wanting a new beginning with this person here because they are in love with this person, but spirit is saying no. No. Tell me more. What's their karma for hurting? Strength. Yeah, look. They're going to be experiencing a broken heart here, okay? It could be maybe this person's already with somebody here, so it could be a third party. They are experiencing defeat here. To someone very weak minded. Tell me more. What's their karma? What's this Three of Swords? What's their karma for hurting group three? Endings. Failed plans. This is a lack of achieving anything here. Stagnation, you know, it's being stuck. It's like you can't move forward here with this third party that they've got feelings for here. And their karma is that you are just going to always experience they're going to experience heartbreak because of what they did to you, okay? They went into a relationship here with lies. Queen of Wands in reverse. Five of Pentacles being left out in the cold. They could have even been played by this person, okay? They may have been manipulated by this person, which is the same manipulation with the Magician here. So they're now in the mindset of feeling very confused, very used. So, you know, this is someone that is unfaithful when she's in reverse with the Queen of Wands. So, and I said about third party as well. So it could be that maybe they had hope for being with this person, maybe on the side, sneaky, sneaky, whatever. But they've been left out in the cold. This person has rejected them, okay? I feel like it was just a thrill of not actually, people get a thrill out of affairs. They do. They get that. And they've been left out in the cold here. They're Money could have taken a bit of a turn here as well. So what's their karma for hurting group three? Knight of Pentacles. This is going to go on for a long time, Spirit's saying here, okay? This is something they're going to experience for a while. What is their karma for hurting group three? There's no healing energy here for this person. They're experience loneliness, unstable relationships. They're going to experience in a lot of things, failing like plans, just anything. They could be having car trouble here. They're not going to be able to let go of this person, whoever it is that they're in love with the Four of Pentacles here. This person does lack control, self-control here. Their karma is they're not going to heal. They're not going to heal from what it is, okay? So even though they did what they did to you, their punishment is literally for getting involved with somebody here. And it's like that energy there is actually the karma that they're receiving, yes, as well as you, but as well as them as well. So it's like what goes around comes around, basically. So where's my karma cards here? So what is their karma for hurting group three? Please, Spirit. So they will never marry. So, this is what I said actually. There's no marriage in their future here with the Hierophant again. This is what they want with this person, but it's never going to happen. They're going to feel used, and I said that as well. I feel like this person actually used them. It was like the thrill of it all. They're experiencing nightmares, tormented by spirit for the way they treated you. Okay, they will be put into a third party situation. Thank you for clarifying their spirit as well. They're going to have a, which if they are attracted to the different, a different sex. I'm trying to be diplomatic here, a bit, have to be sensitive about these things. And if they end up getting involved with another, say, woman or a man gets involved with, you know what I mean? It's never going to satisfy them because that's not the sex that they're attracted to. And it's so sad. This happens to a lot of people, that they can't be with the people that they want to be with. But this person took it out on you, which really wasn't fair at all. So there were no equal give and take in the relationship, which we already saw that there was never any equalness in this connection with you. So now they're going to experience that as well. They're going to have, maybe they're going to catch something. They will always be judged by others. Their partner will cheat, which we've seen quite a few times. The evil eye will be sent their way. No help from other people. Stopped by the police, traffic tickets, which we do have the Chariot on the back of this deck right here. So that, car trouble is what I said. Oh my goodness. Oh, do you know what? Let's take them. Sod it. This person's obviously got a lot of karma coming their way. No doors will open for this person. Business will fail. They'll experience legal issues, damage to property. All their secrets will be exposed. So maybe you did expose this person, or maybe their secrets will eventually come out, being part of the karma that they tried to hide this. And I said that they were hiding, like really trying to protect this secret. Will not be able to find a job. bad skin can experience some acne here. Someone close will steal your man or woman, which we're seeing. This is like basically cheating. Friends, family will stop talking to them, and that could be if their secret is exposed. This might happen. They'll be used for their money and unrequited love, which we're seeing quite a few times here, because what happened to you, it was unrequited love. I'm a big believer in what goes around comes around. So I'm going to leave it there, group three. If you like this reading, please hit like, and you have a lovely day. Much love, guys.